Let's look at these reactions. When zinc atom, it loses 2 electrons. So it becomes positively charged, it becomes Zn2+. When we have sodium atom, neutral sodium atom, it loses 1 electron, it becomes sodium ion, since it loses 1 electron, so we get Na+. Similarly, if we take Fe2+, this means it has already lost 2 electrons. If it loses 1 electron, it becomes Fe3+. Similarly, for a negatively charged ion, say we have S2-, that means the sulfur atom has 2 extra electrons. When it loses 1 electron, now it has only 1 extra electron. So it becomes S-. So the process involving removal of electrons is known as oxidation. So whenever there is removal of electrons, that process is known as oxidation. When we take the reverse, that is, let's look at these reactions. There is addition of electrons. So we have, if we have Cu2+, when we add 2 electrons, since there was a deficiency of 2 electrons, when it takes 2 electrons, it becomes neutral Cu atom. Similarly, if we have sulfur, neutral sulfur atom, when we add 2 electrons, it becomes S2-. So in all these reactions, electrons are being added. So the process involving addition of electrons is known as reduction. So the removal of electrons means oxidation. The addition of electrons means reduction. So if we look at the equation, if we have this equation, the copper ion, that is Cu2+, it becomes Cu. That means it is gaining 2 electrons to become neutral. There is addition of electrons. So this is a reduction reaction. If you look at zinc, neutral zinc atom is losing 2 electrons to become Zn2+. So there is removal of electrons. So this process is known as oxidation. And whenever in a single reaction, both reduction and oxidation takes place simultaneously, that reaction is known as a redox reaction. Why do we name it redox? Because it comes from reduction, oxidation. So whenever there is reduction and oxidation taking place simultaneously in a reaction, that reaction is known as a redox reaction. Let's look at our electrolysis process now. What had we seen? We had seen that the positively charged ions, that is the cations, they migrate towards the cathode, and the negatively charged anions, they migrate towards the anode. So in order to become neutral, the cations, they take the electrons from the cathode, and in order to become neutral, the anions, they give the extra electrons to the anode. So they are losing electrons. So at cathode, there is gain or addition of electrons. So at cathode, reduction is taking place. And similarly at anode, there is removal of electrons. So the anions are giving away the electrons. So at anode, oxidation is taking place. So we observe that in an electrolysis reaction, both reduction and oxidation are taking place simultaneously. So we conclude that electrolysis is a redox reaction. This is because both reduction and oxidation reactions are taking place simultaneously at the cathode and the anode. So electrolysis is always a redox reaction. Let's do a question here. Reduction takes place at which electrode? At cathode or at anode? Let's look at the process again. So this is the electrolysis process. The cations migrate towards the cathode, anions migrate towards the anode. In order to become neutral, the cations, they take the electrons from the cathode. So since electrons are being added, so at cathode, there is reduction taking place. So reduction takes place at cathode. Similarly, at anode, in order to become neutral, the anions lose electrons. So at anode, there is oxidation taking place. So electrolysis is always a redox reaction.